Willets Point is dead. Long live Willets Point. The $3 billion Bloomberg-era project to transform a neighborhood of broken streets and ramshackle auto repair shops across from City Field in Queens appeared dead in 2015, when a state court ruled that the city could not take a piece of Flushing Meadows Corona Park for a gigantic shopping mall and garage as it had planned. Still, bulldozers plowed over dozens of shops as the city used eminent domain to take some of the land and hundreds of immigrant workers lost their jobs. But on Monday, the administration of Mayor Bill de Blasio struck a deal with the original developers for a new version of the plan, which will include 1,100 apartments for low- and moderate-income New Yorkers, a 450-seat school, open space, and retail on 6 acres at Willets Point Boulevard and Roosevelt Avenue. Notably not part of the plan, the mall. Instead of pursuing remnants of the old plan, the de Blasio administration will convene a task force with Melinda Katz, the Queens Borough President, and Francisco Moya, the local city council member, to fashion a framework for developing the remaining 17 acres at the site, which is also known as the Iron Triangle. Related companies and the owners of the New York Mets Fred Wilpon and Saul B. Katz will remain as the designated developers. This is a happy and smarter ending to the first phase of Willets, said Alicia Glenn, deputy mayor for economic development under Mr. de Blasio, who has made affordable housing a keystone of the administration. This is a huge milestone for what we came here to do. Ms. Katz said the new plan would finally put a shovel in the ground. In 2008, Ms. Katz, then a city council member, had sponsored a bill supporting a prior proposal. Even Tony Avella Jr., a Democratic state senator who represents the area and has long opposed the development, approved of the new concept. "I'm not opposed to affordable housing," he said Monday, "if it's affordable to the people who need it most. But that does not mean that planning for phase two will be controversy-free." Ms. Katz has long favored building a soccer stadium at the Willets Point site, near both the National Tennis Center and City Field. In 2013, the Bloomberg administration came close to signing a deal with the New York City Football Club to build a 28,000-seat stadium on the site. Youth soccer leagues who were promised new fields loved the idea, but park advocates opposed turning over park land to a private developer. "I am opposed to a stadium," Mr. Avella said. "We don't need it. Today, there are vacant lots surrounded by chain fences scattered across the Iron Triangle where auto repair shops once stood. Customers came to Willets Point from all over the city and beyond, knowing that they could get a good deal at one of 225 shops and junkyards competing in the neighborhood. But on a recent afternoon, the work bays were empty in the few shops that remain. Five men in bulky coats sat around a card table in 30-degree weather on 36th Avenue waiting for the next customer. "It's bad for us," said Nelson Bautista, 42, who runs C&A Auto Glass. "It's very quiet. The customers see it on the news. It's no more. They go elsewhere." The torturous path of the Willets Point development, where the city has already spent $287 million on buying land, cleaning it of the remains of hazardous chemicals and paying for the relocation of businesses, illustrates the difficulties of building in New York, where projects can expect to encounter environmental hurdles, community opposition, litigation and the riptide of politics, particularly when they fail to address the needs of local residents. The Bloomberg administration first announced plans to redevelop Willets Point in 2002. Initially, the administration identified the district as the location for housing Olympic athletes, part of the city's unsuccessful bid to lure the 2012 Olympic Games. The original plan called for 5,500 apartments, a hotel, a convention center and retail on the entire 62 acres of the Iron Triangle. Mayor Michael R. Bloomberg called for New York's next great neighborhood, on a site littered with deeply potholed streets that were underwater whenever it rained. Along the way, the administration managed to anger property owners, many of the 1,700 people who worked in the Iron Triangle, local politicians, and nearby residents. Even some of the project's original supporters grew disenchanted as Mayor Bloomberg rejiggered the deal with developers. Housing activists like Messenger Thomas Healy, the now-retired pastor of the nearby Our Lady of Sorrows Church, who originally favored the development's 1,900 units of affordable housing, turned against it. The activists felt betrayed when a revised deal put the housing off into an uncertain future and under a 2012 plan agreed to by the city. A 1.4 million square foot mall came to the fore. It was all about the mall, the last thing Queens needs, rather than anything to do with housing, said Ms. Glenn. They had the tail and the dog backwards. Under the terms of that deal, the developers were to remove toxic materials at Willits Point, with a city grant, and build a mall with 200 stores, a theater, and a hotel. The developers agreed to build 2,500 apartments, including 875 for low and moderate income tenants, but not until 2025. The developers had the option of paying the city $35 million to get out of that requirement. As the city moved to condemn the land, Willits Point United, a group of property and business owners, filed a lawsuit. In response to a separate lawsuit from Mr. Avella and the City Club, a small civic group, a state court ruled in 2015 that the city could not use the parking lot next to City Field for the mall, because it was park land. Only the state legislature can convert park land to other uses. Mr. de Blasio, who inherited the project, initially declined to join the developers in appealing the court decision. Behind the scenes, the de Blasio administration was negotiating to put its own stamp on Willits Point, asking the developers to build affordable housing first. The owners of the Mets were not keen on the idea, nor were some elected officials. Hoping for a compromise, the city joined the appeal. But last year the state's highest court upheld the lower court decision and the project seemed to die again. In recent months, the de Blasio administration has worked with Ms. Katz and Mr. Moya to craft a new arrangement with the developers. The developers will be responsible for cleaning the site of toxic materials by the end of 2020, with the first 500 of the 1,100 apartments built by 2022. According to city officials, this project delivers big on the number one priority for people in Queens, finding an affordable place to live, Mr. de Blasio said in a statement Monday. One of the three buildings will be reserved for older tenants and more than one-third of the units will be for households earning less than $43,000, for a family of three. More apartments than under prior proposals. Willits Point has been 12 years of bad politics and broken promises, said Mr. Moya. Now we can look to providing some great housing relief for a lot of people who need it.